interesting story in terms of understanding the entirety of what happened here at GameStop. So hit the thumbs up button, hit the share button, hit the subscribe button. Make sure you subscribe to our channels. We're the best financial channels around, and I think that we can give you some good information. So Richard Marshall and Brian Gonick started buying shares of GameStop in September. They aren't Reddit day traders or Discord users. They are hedge fund managers in New York. And when the stock surged from less than $10 a share to above $400 a share and the dust has settled, they were sitting on a profit of nearly $700 million, one of the greatest fortunes of the January market mania. The GameStop surge is often cast as a triumph of amateurs over professionals, which it was to a degree, but it also was a trade that pitted professionals against other professionals. And few have made more money than Cinvest Management, Mr. Marshall's and Gonick's firm. Quote, when it started its march, we thought something's percolating here, Mr. Marshall, 55 years old, said, but we had no idea how crazy this thing was going to get. Now, what they saw there was I actually wrote my dissertation on this topic. They call it momentum trading. Basically, they saw momentum trading. They saw people that were going to buy more and more of the stock as the stock price went up. And momentum trading works until it doesn't work anymore. It's good until it's bad. It's great until it ain't great. Right. And the point I want to make on that is that the problem with momentum trading is that when you get to the point where there are bubbles and bubbles are taken off to the moon, there's money to be made certainly on the way up and even money to be made on the way down. But what always happens when a stock gets overinflated, overvalued like that, and you end up with what effectively becomes a pump and dump is that somebody always gets hurt. Now, we've talked about that point, so I'm not going to belabor that issue, but I want to make that clear point to you that not everybody wins when these things happen.